Hello everyone, this reading comes from chapter 12 of the book. It has parallels with the story of the Cyclops from the Odyssey. Here, Bloom is attacked by a one-eyed monster in the shape of the xenophobic citizen, who is based on the famous nationalist figure Michael Cusack, the founder of the Gaelic Athletic Association in Ireland.
This long chapter features a number of characters drinking a number of pints in a Dublin city centre pub called Bernard Kiernan's, which is the pub just over here. So obviously, because it's in a Dublin pub, there's lots of funny dialogue and it has many amazing demonstrations of Joyce's great flair for language. However, one of the reasons we chose this extract is because it also features Joyce's great commitment to tolerance and inclusion and his absolute rejection of exclusionary nationalism that was quite popular in Ireland at the time.
So in Bloom's simple and dignified statement of his own Irishness and his own Jewishness at the end of the extract, and his rejection of the hatred that lies behind prejudice and racism and anti-Semitism, Joyce demonstrates a commitment to tolerance that was sadly all too rare in the 20th century, and indeed on available evidence also in our 21st century. We really hope that you enjoy.
I apologise to anyone from Dublin here today. I was just passing the time of day with old Troy of the DMP at the corner of Aber Hill there, and be damned, but a bloody chimney sweep came along and near drove his gear into me eye. I turned around to let him have the weight of me tongue, but who should I see dodging along Stony Batter? Only Joe Hines. "Hello, Joe," says I, "how are you blowing? Did you see that bloody chimney sweep near shoved me eye with his brush?"
"Sutslop, who's the old bollocks you were talking to?"
"Old Troy. I was on the force. I've two minds not to give the fellow in charge for obstructing the thoroughfare with his brooms and ladders."
"What are you doing round these parts?"
"Devil as much," says I. "There's a bloody big foxy thief beyond the garrison church at the corner of Chicken Lane. Old Troy was just giving me a wrinkle about him. Lifted any god's quantity of tea and sugar to pay £3 a week. Said he had a farm around the country. Down off a hop me thumb by the name of Moses Herzog over there on Hepburn Street."
"Are you strict TT?"
"Not taking anything between drinks," says I.
"What about paying our respects to our friend?"
"Who?" says I. "Sure he's in John of God's off his head, the poor man."
"Drinking his own stuff?"
"Aye," says I. "Whiskey and water on the brain."
"Come around now to Barney Kiernan's. I want to see the citizen."
So we turned into Barney Kiernan's, and sure enough, there was a citizen up in the corner having a great confab with himself and his bloody mangy mongrel, Gary Ohm. And he waiting for what the sky would drop in the name of the drink. Bloom was talking and talking with John Wise. And he quite excited with his dun duckety mud coloured mug in him and his old plum eyes rolling about.
"Persecution. All the history of the world is full of it. Perpetuating national hatred among nations."
"But do you know what a nation means?"
"Yes."
"What is it?"
"A nation? A nation is the same people living in the same place."
"By God then, if that's so, I'm a nation for being in the same place for the last 5 years." So of course everyone had a laugh at Bloom, and says he, trying to muck out of it.
Or also living in different places."
"That covers my case," says Joe. "What is your nation, if I may ask?" says the citizen.
"Ireland. I was born here. Ireland."
The citizen said nothing, only cleared his spit of gullet and gob, and he spat a red bank oyster out of him right into the corner. "After you would have pushed, Joe," says he, taking out his handkerchief to swab himself dry. "Here you are, citizen," says Joe. "Take that in your right hand and repeat after me the following words.
The much treasured and intricately embroidered ancient Irish facecloth attributed to Solomon O'Droma and Manus Tumultock O'Macdonough, authors of the Book of Ballymote, was then carefully produced and called forth prolonged admiration at the sight of
Glendalough,
the lovely lakes of Killarney,
the ruins of Clonmacnoise,
Cong Abbey,
Glen Island 12 pence,
Ireland's Eye,
the Green Hills of Tala,
Crowpatrick,
the brewery of Mr. Arthur Guinness Song and Company Limited,
Loch Naze Banks,
the Vales of Oka,
Issos Tower,
the Mappas Obelisk,
St. Patrick Dunn's Hospital,
Cape Clare,
the Glen of Aherlo,
Nature's Castle,
the Scotch House,
Rathdown Union Workhouse at Loughlinstown,
Tullamore Jail,
Castlecar Rapids,
Killymack Channel,
the Cross at Monaster Boys,
Drury's Hotel,
St. Patrick's Purgatory,
the Salmon Leaf,
Middle College Refectory,
Curley's Hole,
the Three Birthplaces of the First Duke of Wellington,
the Rock Up Cashel,
the Bog of Allen,
the Henry Street Warehouse,
Finals Cave.
All these moving scenes are still there for us today, rendered more beautiful still by the waters of sorrow which have passed over them and by the rich incrustations of time.
Shove her over a drink, says I. Which is which? That's mine, says Joe. And the devil said to the policeman.
And I belong to a race too, says Bloom, that is hated and persecuted. Also now, this very moment, this very instant.
God, he near burnt his fingers with the butt of his old cigar.
I'm talking about injustice, but it's no use. Force, hatred, history, all that. That's not life for men and women, insult and hatred. And everybody knows that it's the very opposite of that that is really life.
What?
Love. I mean the opposite of hatred. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Everyone to our 2023 Bloomsday celebration here at the Peanut Gallery up there, here at the House of Blues and Jazz. It's the first time we've had our celebration here, and I think it's a wonderful venue. The building is over 100 years old, so it's appropriate place to have it. It is great to see everyone here after a 2-year hiatus. Nice to be able to meet you again in person. We actually started our Bloomsday events last night, yesterday evening, with a talk by Professor Dye about